Wearing a robe? Check. Baphomet symbol around the neck? Check. Crazy eyes? Check. Note to self, bring a mirror next time to be able to adjust the optimal level of eye craziness. Everything is ready for the experiment. An audience. Problematic, but not critical. You there, boy. Stay out of this. It is counterproductive to stand in the way of scientific progress.
Who's that? I don't know her.
Greetings, boys and girls. I am your sister in sin, a devotee of Lord Baphomet's dark will, and so on and so forth.
She looks like one of us, but she talks kinda weird. Who's there with you?
Who? Oh, them! Just an audience, they don't matter. Consider them a supplementary component of the coming experiment. In the name of our Lord Baphomet, please be so kind as to undertake a little test of your competency in our wicked cause. Let's start with something simple. So here's my first question. What is Lord Baphomet's favorite weapon?
We will not answer to you.
Our lord can wield any kind of weapon. He is all powerful.
Wrong. He wields no weapons at all. He doesn't need any. He just gores his enemies with his horns.
That is correct. But still, boy, no prompting, please. This experiment has taken quite a surprising turn. I would never have expected the followers of the great Baphomet to be baffled by such a simple question. Fine. Let's recalibrate the difficulty and proceed with the next question. Please name Lord Baphomet's sacred animal.
A bull! Of course everybody knows that.
Yep. And a cow.
I'd like to ask you to stop prompting them, but it seems they could do with a prompt or two. It appears the experiment has yielded results which are as unexpected as they are incredible. Baphomet's cultists have not the slightest idea about who Baphomet really is, let alone any in-depth knowledge of his ideology or philosophy. I'm positive that this news will cause a sensation in widest scientific circles.
Damn it! She's right. I'm a shitty excuse for a cultist. And my mother used to tell me to become a plowman.
Hey, take it easy! We've only had two questions. You there, come on, ask another one. We'll get the next one!
Is there any sense in continuing? You cannot answer the simplest of questions. I am ashamed of all of you, as cultists and as individuals.
Please, ask again. I can answer, I'm sure I can.
How do you spell Baphomet's name?
B-A-F-A... Oh, screw it. To hell with Baphomet. I thought it was gonna be fun, but instead there are all these questions. I'm done here. I'm going back to my home village, back to my mother.
Hey, wait! You there! How dare you stir up discord in our ranks! Grab her and tie her up! And her entire entourage, too!
The experiment is complete. Unable to deal with the questions, the cultists decide to deal with the examiner instead. A typical reaction for a person who has never been burdened with any intelligence. Now you're gonna start hitting each other, aren't you? Please, proceed. I won't interrupt.
Save the last one for me.
Time to share your treasures!
You've crossed the wrong mark. Attack!
Hey!
result is statistically predictable, especially considering their intelligence level. What about you, boy? Are you ready to answer some questions for the good of science? Let's proceed with the experiment. My first question is simple. Which colors does the goddess Iomade prefer? This answer is correct. It is comforting to meet at least one educated person in the melting pot of ignorance that is Canabras today. Let's proceed. Did Aradin take part in any crusade before he died? Your answer is correct. Aradin's death dates to 4606, and that is precisely the year when the World Wound was opened. The first crusade started back in 4622. Your knowledge would make Mendev's crusaders proud. My final question is, what is the title that Arilu Vorlesh bears? Is she the architect of the World Wound, the Lord of the Labyrinth, or the Border Inquisitor of the Shapeless Abyss? That's correct! Most excellent! You successfully answered all of my questions! Splendid! Amazing! This is a breakthrough! I thank you for your cooperation. It seems to me that I owe you an explanation. My name is Nenio. I am an explorer, a pilgrim, a yet-to-be-recognized scientific luminary, future author of the Great Encyclopedia Galarianica, and rector of all Absalom's universities at once. Future rector, I should say. I also know several spells. It is so heartening to see you strive for knowledge. I have been conducting an experiment comparing the intellectual abilities of the average cultist with those of the average crusader. And I must admit that you passed the test with flying colors. This does offer a glimmer of hope for the future of Crusade. I have always claimed that despite the popular beliefs about the limited intellectual abilities of those in the army, at least some of them can be considered educated. It pleases me to see that I was correct. I apologize for an injury to your ego, but your name is irrelevant on the grand scale of the universe. Thus, it cannot possibly interest me. I will forget it as soon as I hear it. To avoid unnecessary confusion, I'd prefer to not know it at all. Yes. Do you wish to become my follower? To accompany me on my expeditions to the World Wound? To assist me in my experiments? To run errands for me? Perhaps even to write down my deepest thoughts for the benefit of future generations? Oh, how splendid! Of course, I agree! Truth be told, I have no money to pay you. But you will be aiding the progress of science, and that is its own reward. Huh? What? Oh, yes, the dangers and these battles. Of course, I will follow your orders. I place my life in your capable hands, so I can focus on the things that really matter. Excellent, you're hired. To think that I finally found someone to accompany me. 27 crusaders before you said no. Not one of them saw the undeniable appeal of my offer. Your first assignment is to take me to a safe place. I have to admit that today's experiment has left me quite tired.
Press on.
Thank you.
passage ahead. Our path leads on. I will guide us. Godspeed.